It's day number two of 10 Rhythms in 10 Days. I'm going to take a look at the intro of Accelerator by Pain of Salvation off their 2020 album Panther. This was suggested to me on Instagram by Daniel Krause, so thank you, Daniel. I'm a massive Pain of Salvation fan. In fact, I just put out a full analysis video on their song Fandango a couple of weeks ago, and this rhythm from Accelerator sounds considerably more complex on first listen than it actually is. So what's going on here? First, I'm going to look for a discernible beat or pulse, and it's very clearly happening in the open hi-hat. And I usually listen for cymbals first when trying to determine a pulse, as that's the most common place to hear it in rock-based music. From here, I'm going to figure out the subdivision of the beats, or how many notes are happening within each beat. It doesn't sound like 16th notes to me, which would be the most common, so I'm going to try triplets or three notes per beat. And that works perfectly. So what we have here is compound meter meaning three notes per beat. Now I'll look for a repeating pattern and try to determine how many beats are in each measure. I'm hearing a pattern that's seven beats long, and going forward to where the vocal starts confirms that it is seven beats here. There's also this pulsing keyboard part which makes that pretty clear. So there are seven beats here, and each beat has three notes, for a total of 21 eighth notes. And I'm going to write this as 21/8. You could also think of this as 7/4 with triplets, but 21/8 is going to be a little bit easier to read in notation. There are a total of four measures of 21/8 in this intro rhythm. The exact same pattern happens in the guitar and kick drum each measure, except for at the very end of the last measure. This is the most confusing part of this section, and it was the one thing that really threw me off at first. On each repeat of these four measures, none of the instruments hit the downbeat of the first measure. They play the eighth note right before the downbeat and hold over it. The drums also abandon the steady pulse and the hi-hat a few beats before this happens. The combination of these two small changes makes it very difficult to feel the groove, but here it is with a metronome. This is a really clever way to make a rhythm feel a little bit more complex. We're so used to feeling downbeats that skipping over them can be rather confusing at first. For me, it makes this whole section a little more interesting to listen to, especially on repeated listens. In the second measure of this pattern, there's also one beat where the hi-hat doesn't continue that steady dotted quarter note pulse. On beat four, it plays a quarter note and then a half note, and it's a pretty small change, but once again, it's very effective. This entire riff is basically one repeated rhythm on one note, but skip the downbeat on the repeat and change up the drums in a few spots and you end up with a really interesting and pretty confusing rhythm. That's two rhythms down and eight to go. If you enjoyed this lesson, stay tuned for the rest and subscribe, hit the bell notification, like, comment, share, all that good stuff. Till next time, stay proggy.